Hello friends, myself Pradeep Singh here on the behalf of Engineers Institute of India. Once again I am here. Response sheet has been released by IIT and I was out of Delhi for few days. तो मैं आप लोगों के कांटेक्ट में यूट्यूब के थ्रू नहीं हो पाया, अदरवाइज तो कांटेक्ट में हमेशा ही रहता हूँ आपके किसी सोशल मीडिया के थ्रू और फोन कॉल के थ्रू. व्हेन आई रीच दिल्ली देन आई हैव सीन द रिस्पॉन्स शीट एज यू हैव सेंड टू अवर ईमेल आईडी, ऑफिशियल ईमेल आईडी ऑफ माई स्टूडेंट्स. तो हमने देखा कि बच्चों ने बहुत ही अच्छा किया, बहुत ही प्राउड फील हुआ एंड उसके बिहाफ पर मैं दोबारा हम बोल सकते हैं कि इस बार भी हम अच्छा ही रिजल्ट देंगे और ये प्री डिक्लेयर्ड रिजल्ट है. ठीक है, बाकी हम वो रिजल्ट के बारे में बाद में भी डिस्कस करेंगे. बट कुछ क्वेश्चंस मेरे पास, बहुत सारी क्वेरीज आ रही थी कि कुछ क्वेश्चंस ऐसे हैं जो सॉल्यूशंस उसके अभी नहीं डाले गए थे बिकॉज वी आर नॉट अवेलेबल एट दिल्ली सेंटर. ओके, तो नाउ वी आर अवेलेबल हेयर एंड वी आर प्रोसीडिंग फॉर द सोल्यूशन. तो कुछ क्वेश्चन ऐसे हैं जो टिपिकल क्वेश्चन है, दैट आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ओनली हेयर. अदरवाइज ऑल द सिंपल क्वेश्चन विल डिस्कस लेटर ऑन, बट अभी मैं आज थोड़ा सा जो टिपिकल थोड़ा सा अलग क्वेश्चन, मैं अलग नहीं बोलूंगा, ऑल आर द फ्रॉम द क्लास रूम्स एंड कॉन्सेप्ट बेस्ड, बट हाँ थोड़ा सा अलग है, अच्छे क्वेश्चन मैं बोलूंगा उनको, तो उसके बारे में हम थोड़ा डिस्कस करेंगे. ओके, तो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन that you are going to see here on the screen. A tank initially contains a gas mixture with 21 mole percent oxygen, 79 mole percent nitrogen. Now, questions ko solve karne ke liye, first of all, we have to be read question carefully. Okay? Now, what the question want to say? The first step to solve any question is to read carefully. Okay? Much more time you will spend on reading the question, the less time you will spend for solving the question. Okay, and every time that is the only mantra for solving any paper, any questions. Now, a tank initially contains a gas mixture with 21 mole percent oxygen and 79 mole percent nitrogen. Pure nitrogen enters the tank and a gas mixture of nitrogen and oxygen exit the tank. Okay, the molar flow rate of both inlet and exit streams is 8 mole per second. So, up to this line, what we have interpreted it, that a tank is there, this is a tank, a vessel you can say. This tank initially contain a mixture, mean initially means at time t equal to 0, it contains a mixture of 21 mole percent oxygen and obviously 79 mole percent nitrogen. It is initial mixture of oxygen and nitrogen in the tank. Now pure nitrogen enters the tank, means here nitrogen entering, no oxygen is going to enter, only nitrogen is going to enter, that's why I am going to only write here nitrogen. Okay, and a gas mixture of nitrogen and oxygen exit the tank. Jo tank se nikal raha hai, whatever is going to release from the tank is a mixture of oxygen and nitrogen, so that is mixture of oxygen plus nitrogen here. Okay, the molar flow rate of both inlet and exit streams is 8 mole per second. It means here it is also nitrogen is entering at 8 mole per second. Oxygen plus nitrogen is also going to exit. Mixture is going to exit is also at the 8 mole per second. Okay, now in addition, use the following data and assumptions. Now there is assumption, and assumption is make this question very simpler. Now assume the tank contains are well mixed. It means it is well mixed. What does it means? It means it is acting as a continuous steel tank. And what is the basic features of continuous steel tank? Well mixed, it means whatever the concentration at any given time we are going to observe inside the tank, the same concentration we are going to expect at the exit because of only uniform mixing. That is a basic feature of this assumption. Now assume ideal gas behavior, means gas is obviously, because otherwise it will become complex, so that to make the calculation simpler they have told you assume the gas is ideal gas. Now temperature and pressure inside the tanks are held constants, means variables are not going to change, temperature and pressure are not going to change. Now molar density of the gas mixture in the tank is constant at 40 mole per meter cube. Means density of the mixture, molar density of mixture is going to assume constant, and it is equal to 40 mole per meter cube. Okay, now if the volume of the tank is 20 meter cube, they have given the volume of the tank is 20 meter cube, then find out the time in second required for oxygen contained in the tank to decrease to 1 mole per second. Means how much time it will require to reduce the concentration of oxygen from 21% to 1%, because initially at time t equal to 0, the concentration of oxygen in the tank was found to be 21 mole per second, but obviously as nitrogen is going to enter, what happened, the concentration of oxygen and nitrogen both is going to change. So that's why they have asked you how much time it will require to reach the concentration of oxygen to reach at 1 mole per second level. Are you getting a point? That is simple mole balance concept, mole concept, process calculation, and it is basically chemical engineering concept, basic of chemical engineering concept. And obviously here, as it is a flow process, because mass in, mass out, simple, we are going to apply the mole balance now. And here obviously it is very easy to apply the oxygen balance, because oxygen is not going to enter, and that term will be zero. Oxygen is only going to out, and some oxygen is going to accumulate. And be careful, my dear students, that process, obviously someone can argue that this is 8 mole per second, that is also 8 mole per second, then there should be no accumulation. Obviously there should be no any accumulation if you are going to apply the total balance, but if you are going to apply the component balance, then there should be accumulation. Are you getting my point? That's why even it is 8 mole per second, it is also 8 mole per second, but it is no accumulation should be there, but only that should be said as no accumulation when I am going to apply the balance on the behalf of overall balance, not for the component balance. Okay, so here I am going to apply the component balance, and obviously it is very easy to apply the oxygen component balance. So if I am going to apply the oxygen balance here, O2 balance, then rate of O2 in, simple, the O2 in is zero, because it is pure, only nitrogen is going to enter, oxygen is not present in the inlet. O2 is zero, minus rate of flow of a molar rate at which the mole of oxygen is going to out. Now, and it is very simple, because molar fluid is given, total mole, 8 mole per second, it is a total. Be careful, but I have to find out what is the molar fluid of oxygen, and to find the molar fluid of oxygen, obviously we have to be multiply by its mole fraction, and let's say the mole fraction of oxygen is XO2. Okay, now because I am going to apply the balance at any given time t, at any time t, oxygen balance at any time t. Now it is rate of inlet of oxygen is zero, rate of outflow of oxygen is 8, is the total molar fluid, into mole fraction of oxygen, that is the molar fluid of oxygen going to out, and here it should be accumulation, and accumulation should be obviously of what, d of dt of moles of oxygen. It is very common sense. Now my question is, how can you find the moles of oxygen? Now moles of oxygen is obviously how much moles of oxygen in the tank. And now obviously total volume of the tank was given, total volume is given V. Now it is obviously meter cube. Now if I am going to apply, because V is a meter cube, if I am going to apply multiply by density of the mixture, so V, it is meter cube, and molar density is given as rho of mix molar density, it is obviously mole per meter cube. Then meter cube cancel, it is only mole, and it is total moles in the tank. But I have to find out the moles of only what, oxygen, then again I have to be multiplied by the mole fraction of oxygen, XO2. Now my dear students, once again here, as I told you, at any given time t, since the tank is well mixed, so that whatever the concentration, whatever the composition of the oxygen within the tank, the same should be at the exit at that time. Obviously that is going to change with the time to time, but at any given instant at the time, that will remain same as of the exit. Okay, now then obviously here minus of 8 x of O2, is equal to d of dt rho of molar or mixture you can say into V into x of O2, and volume is constant, density of mixture is constant in the assumption it they have given, into V d of x of O2 over dt. Now solution already I have given, okay, when the response sheet has been released on the same date after few hours I have given the solution, okay, answer in answer key minus 8 into x O2. And if we are going to observe the data as data I have already written here, then density of mixture, volume density of mixture is given as 20 and volume is given as 40 d of x O2 over dt. Now it is obviously 800 and 8 it will cancel out, it is 100. Now if we solve, then obviously we will get what, minus of dx O2 over x O2, okay, is equal to here you can solve minus 0 point or plus here 0.01 dt. Just integrate it. When time t equal to 0, the concentration or mole fraction of oxygen in the tank is found to be what, 0.21. now at what time the concentration of oxygen is going to found to be what, 0.1%, means 0.01. and obviously when you will solve, you will get ln of what, 0.01 upon 0.21, a minus sign obviously there, and this is 0.01 t, and if you solve, t is 304.45 second. That is your answer. Now it means here in that question the simple we have to be apply what, component balance, nothing else. Are you getting my point? Okay, now come to the next question. Now my dear students, that is also the very good question, and this question, if you are able to recall, if you are able to recall the concept and if you will spend some time, then obviously it is very very simple question of the GATE 2020 examination. Now the question is equilibrium data for the binary mixture of E and F. The two component is given, E and F, at two different pressure is shown in the figure. Now that is obviously your equilibrium diagram at the two different pressure. One is at 20 kilopascal, that is obviously your diagonal line, that is diagonal line. Now and this is the equilibrium curve at 20 kilopascal, it is found to be somewhat linear, and it is the equilibrium curve at 100 kilopascal. Are you getting a point? And one more thing we should observe here, that is not going to start from 0, that is going to start from 0.8. okay, now it is desired to process a feed containing 80 mole percent E and 20 mole percent F, means we have to process, we have binary mixture of E and F, and in the feed the 80 mole percent E is present and 20 mole percent F is present, and obtain a product with a purity of 99.5% of E, means our objective is to obtain a product with purity of 0.995 mole fraction of E. A sequence of two distillation columns, one operating at pressure P1, and now obviously here to obtain that purity they have used the sequence of column, one is operating at pressure P1, other is operating at pressure P2, is employed for the operation as shown below. Now that is figure is given. Now this is the tank operating at pressure P1, this is the second tank operating at pressure P2 column, okay. Now and obviously as in the question they have given, it is a mixture of E and F, you know, E and F, yes, obviously E and F, where E is 0.8 and obviously F is 0.2, and it is very obvious that we have to be obtain the product of quality 0.9 or purity 0.995 or 99.5%, okay. Now and here obviously mole fraction of E obtained in the distillation obtained from the column first is 0.9, here it is 0.9, means here E is 0.8 and here E is found to be 0.9, means purity has been increased, but we have to increase the purity not only up to 0.9, but we have to increase the purity up to 0.995, okay, so that again it has to be entered in the second column. Okay now then which of the following option is correct, kaun sa option correct hai. So it is very simple, just observe the graph. Listen, since as we have seen here that here the high purity product is going to obtain from the top 0.9 here, and question is what should be the pressure in the first tank. Now as far as pressure is concerned, listen, as we are going to see the 0.9 is here. The product which are coming out from the first tank have quality of or purity of 0.9, and here it is 0.9, and we are going to observe this is diagonal line, and if it is diagonal line then obviously here, and since the product is going to come from the top, product is going to come from the top of the first tank, it means your driving force should be always positive, means alpha should be more than 1. Okay, now and here we can see the alpha is more than 1 only for this equilibrium curve 20 kilopascal. The equilibrium curve at 20 kilopascal has found to be equilibrium driving force positive, it means alpha will be more than 1. Now alpha is more than 1, are you getting a point? Now if alpha is more than 1, then obviously here the more volatile component will come out from the top. Okay, and since it is 0.9, up to 0.9 you can see, but if we are going to observe the 100 kilopascal curve, you will see that only up to 0.87 around, you can say 0.86 or 87, now the driving force is positive, but at this point the driving force becomes zero, and here driving force becomes negative, so that it can never be possible. So that obviously the first column pressure should be only 20 kilopascal, only 20 kilopascal. Now the second thing is that, what about the second? Obviously if first is 20, then second should be 100. Why 100? One more clue is here. Why 100? It is very obvious, because the feed which are going to enter in the second tank have quality of 0.9. You can see here. The feed which are going to enter in the second tank or second column has purity of 0.9. Okay. Now if it's 0.9 and the 0.9, then here apart from 0.9, here driving force is very very more as compared to driving force at 20 kilopascal, means driving force at 100 kilopascal is very very more than driving force at 20 kilopascal. Are you getting the point? No. And that's why obviously we have to be go for what, even if it is negative, even driving force is negative, but still driving force is more, and driving force negative means alpha less than 1, and if alpha is less than 1, my dear students, listen carefully, if alpha is less than 1, then obviously what will happen? Now still the separation is there, alpha more than 1 separation is there, in that case E will be released from top of the column. If alpha is less than 1, much less than 1, still the separation is there, but now this time F will be from the top, not E. E will become from the bottom, as already I have discussed in the classroom, that alpha more than 1 does not, alpha less than 1 does not mean that separation is not going to happen, separation is there, but only that alpha less than 1, it means the second component, the second, let's say A and B, two component is there, A is more volatile and B is less volatile, then alpha AB is more than 1, it means the A component will be from the top and B will be from the bottom. But if alpha BA is less than 1, what it means? Means B from the top and A from the bottom. The simple separation is there. Only driving force has been reversed. Now, from the 0.9 onward up to 1, you have seen the driving force is very, very high. Okay, even it is negative, it means separation is there, but now the E will come from the bottom, not from the top. Okay, and solution of this I have just, when the answer key has been released, just immediately after 1 or 2 hours we have released the answer key. Okay, now and for this obviously the answer is what, the first column has pressure 20 kilopascal, second column has pressure of 100 kilopascal. Okay, and high purity is recovered from the bottom of the column too. That is the only reason, and reason I have discussed. Are you getting a point? So that is the second question. Now come to the next here. Now this is the question from the heat transfer, you can say heat transfer or you can say process calculation, whatever you can say. Now but already these types of questions we have discussed in the classroom, okay, and no one can say that this is this concept we have not discussed. Okay, now an aqueous suspension at 60 degree centigrade is fed to the first column of a double effect forward feed evaporator. Forward feed evaporator. Forward feed means the feed and steam both should be entered in the same direction. Okay, with a mass flow rate of 1.25 kg per second. Now that is your feed temperature. First of all, we have to be infer the data. We have to collect the data whenever we are going to read the question. Now feed temperature is given as 60 degree Celsius. Now and it is entering in the first effect. It is entering in the first effect of the double effect. Total effect is 2, but this feed having temperature of 60 degree Celsius is entering in the first effect of double effect forward effect evaporator with a mass flow rate of 1.25 kg per second. Here it is given mass flow rate of the feed is given 1.25 kg per second. The sum of the rates of water evaporated from the first and second effect. Now obviously since it is a forward effect, I am going to make a figure clear here. This is the two effect, first effect and second effect. This is the feed, this is the steam obviously, and whatever the vapor is going to form here, this vapor is entering here as a heating media, will come here, and whatever the product will come from the first will enter as a feed to the second. That is your product. Okay, now here what is given, 1.25 kg per second, that is mass flow rate, and let's say V1, let's say it is V2. V1 plus V2 is the total water evaporated, and summation in the problem they have given, the summation of these two are, first of all whatever the data is given we have to write, sum of rates of water evaporated from the first and second effect is 1 kg per second. So obviously V1 plus V2 is given as 1 kg per second. That's it. Okay, now next one, the temperature of the exit stream from the first and second effect are 100 degree Celsius. Temperature of the exit streams from the first and second effects are 100 degree Celsius and 60 degree Celsius respectively. Okay, now it means whatever stream is going to release here, that is at temperature of air. First effect may, it is given, let me check here. So obviously here this is T1, this is T2, and here temperature is 100, because if it is 100 then obviously the streams are also living at the same 100, and it is 60 degree Celsius. Streams are also at 60 degree Celsius, nothing to worry about that. Okay, 100 and 60 they have given in the question. Now come to the next here, specific heat of the aqueous suspension and latent heat of phase change of water to be 4 kilojoule per kg per Kelvin and 2200 kilojoule per kg per Kelvin respectively. They have given the latent heat of vaporization of water and CP. So CP is given and lambda is given, just we have to write here. The CP is 4 kilojoule per kg per Kelvin, and lambda for vaporization of water, and since steam is also there, steam is also water, then no need to worry about that. That is also given as what, 2200 kilojoule per kg, that is given here. Now then we have to find out what steam economy. First of all we should know what is economy in the multiple effect evaporator. Economy definition is totally different from the single effect. In the case of multiple, in the case of multiple effect evaporator, economy is defined as total amount of water evaporated per kg of steam fed in the first. Means through per kg of steam fed in the first, how much total amount of water is going to evaporate, we have to calculate first. Means we know very well the total amount of water evaporated is what, 1 kg per second. Total amount of water, because economy, first of all I have to define steam economy. Steam economy is V1 plus V2 upon total amount, let's say it is S upon S, total amount of water evaporated per kg of steam fed. 1 kg steam fed करने से कितना water evaporated हुआ है, that is called economy in the multiple effect. तो ये तो given है S. Only we have to find out what amount of steam in kg per second. This is the mass flow rate of the steam fed. So what is the thing that we have to be calculate to find our answer, to find our steam economy is what? S. The question is, how can you find the S? Now it is very simple. First of all, we have to apply the mole balance, mass balance, or you can say also energy balance. So as far as mass balance is concerned, let's say we are going to assume that V1 is equal to X. Okay, this is X kg per second. Then obviously here V2 should be 1 minus X. It is very common sense, kg per second, because V1 plus V2 is 1. Then if V1 is X, then V2 is obviously 1 minus X. Any problem? No. And if it is 1.25, if overall balance is concerned on the first effect, then obviously your 1.25 is total feed is going to enter. Total feed is going to enter what? It is energy. Don't consider this. F equal to what? V plus L. Then obviously here is equal to X plus, let's say, L1. And we can find L1 is what? 1.25 minus X. Any problem? No. That is all about your balance. Now, second thing we have to be applied about energy balance over the first. As far as energy balance is concerned, already I have discussed the rate law. What? F total amount, you can say S lambda S. Whatever energy we have supplied by condensing the steam, where it goes? Where does it go? It's simply whatever energy humne jo supply kiya hai by condensing the steam S lambda S, some of the energy, some of that energy will increase the temperature to its boiling point temperature, and rest of that will go for vaporization. It means F Cp into T minus Tf, here T1 obviously, because here temperature is T1, plus V1 into lambda V. That's it. Because whatever energy we have supplied by condensing the steam, where does it go? Some of that will contribute, will consume to increase the temperature of the feed to its boiling point temperature. And here boiling point temperature is 100, because streams are living at 100 degrees Celsius in the first effect. It is given in the problem. Now, it is a first here, and S lambda S, because it is also water, okay, because nothing is given about that, so that we have to assume the simplicity, we have to not increase our complexity. Now, because it is also water dilute, we have to assume, then lambda S is given as 2200, F is given as 1.25, Cp is given as 4, energy is unit is balance, T1 is given as 100, TF feed is coming in at 60, plus V1 already I told you it is X, and the lambda B is again 2200. Now from this equation, it is the first equation, are you getting? Now similarly, we can go for the energy balance for the second effect. As far as energy balance for the second effect is concerned, I'm going to write here only. Second equation. Now energy balance over the second, my dear students, what is going to in? V1 into lambda, because that stream will condense and provide the heat for vaporization. Then obviously here that should be V1 into, just like S lambda S, here V1 into lambda S. Are you getting my point? Now whatever energy is going to given by condensing the steam, where does it go? Again the same thing, some of them will go for increasing the temperature of the stream from its feed temperature to boiling temperature. And here obviously, here the stream which are going to enter here, L1 is given, L1 already I told you, first I'm going to write simple L1 into Cp into T2 minus TF, and TF is 100, are you getting? Now plus rest will go for vaporization, V2 into lambda V. Now just I'm going to put the value all V1 is given as X, lambda is 2200, L1 is, I've told you, 1.25 minus X from the mass balance, Cp is 4, now T2 is here given 60 minus 100, feed streams are already energy. Now plus V2 is here 1 minus X into lambda V is again 2200. Now this is the third equation. And now my dear students, on solving this equation, on solving, let me check, let me match here. That is exactly correct. Now on solving, we'll find for x, and x is found to be 0.439. If you solve from this equation, that you will get the x equal to 0.439. Now, and obviously when we are going to, when we will obtain the x, just put this x in the equation number second, here x, put here x, and then solve for s. And if we'll solve for x, on putting x, on putting value of x in equation second, we get the value of s. S is what? Total mass rate of steam entering in the first effect, and that is found to be 0.5295 kg per second. The solution already we have uploaded. Now then, as far as economy is concerned, I told you to find the economy, we have to only find out what? V1 plus V2, total amount of water evaporated to steam fed in the first effect, and this is given already. One steam fed is 0.5295, and if you will solve, you will get 1.88, that is your steam economy. That's all. Okay, now it means that is the simple calculations and the combined concept of heat transfer and process calculations. Okay, now that is the one more question, that is very good question they have asked in the GATE 2020. Consider, that is based on vertical falling film. Consider a vertically falling film of water over an impermeable wall hai jo impermeable hai. Okay, the film is in contact with the static pool of a non-reactive pure gases, means that liquid film, just like here you can assume that is your vertical film is there, vertical wall is there, and over this some thickness of liquid film is falling. Okay, and that liquid film is contact with what? Non-reactive pure gas. Now the gas diffuses into the water. Okay, gas is going to diffuse into the water film over the entire height of falling film. The height of film is 1 meter, thickness is 10⁻⁴ meter, velocity of water averaged over film thickness is 0.01 meter per second, gas concentration averaged over film thickness is given, it is a concentration profile. Why kya hai? That is very important. Why is the vertical position in meter measured from the top of the column? It is a vertical downward position. In addition, use following data and assumptions. Flow is fully developed, it means the profile velocity whatever is given is not going to change with the location. Fully developed, it means the velocity does not going to change. Now and it is obviously average velocity. The width of the film is much larger than the thickness of film. Jo width hai film ki, it is much larger than the thickness of width of the film is much larger than thickness. It means that simply indicates that we can assume one dimensional. Are you getting a point? It is very very important to know the concept of assumption. Assumption is very very important. What is meaning of that? Means width, I will discuss when I will draw the figure. The width is very very large than the thickness. It means the variation in the direction of width is negligible. All the variations are only in what? Y direction. Okay, and the dissolved gas concentration is invariant over the width. That's I told you already. Now solubility of the gas in water is Ci. Solubility means sometimes Ca star, and here it is given Ci. Ci means what? Whatever solubility, maximum solute can be dissolved is what? Solubility is Ci. And pure water enter at y equal to 0. Means at y equal to 0, the water is pure, water is free from solute. Okay, and the evaporation of water is negligible. No water is going to evaporate, means mass is conserved. Okay, now we have to find out mass transfer coefficient on the liquid side in mm per second averaged over the entire length of falling film. We have to find out average mass transfer coefficient. Obviously average, because concentration is going to change from one location to other location in y direction, and so that we have to be calculate average. Now, and one more thing, I have told you many times that whenever anything is going to vary with the vary in any direction, we have to be assume or differential cell balance concept in that direction. Jis direction mein variation hoga, us direction mein hume ek cell assume karna padega. Ye concept har jagah lagate hain, heat transfer, mass transfer, CRE, whatever is there, Okay, now whenever any variables are going to vary with the space, in that space, in that direction of space, we have to assume a small differential element, and that approach is called as cell balance approach. Okay, now then what is the concept behind that? Listen, it is very very good question. I am going to solve here. Listen, here in this case, just simple, they have given there is a wall. It is a wall is here, and the width of the wall, width is very very large. Let's say ek wall hai, iski width hai, this is W, and over this wall some liquid is falling. Here liquid is falling. This you can assume here, this is the figure. Are you getting? This is the liquid, just like blue hai pani, you know, like that. Okay, that is your blue color is the liquid which is going to fall, and they have given this is the y equal to 0, and there is y direction in the problem. They have given it is y direction, and there is thickness is, dear my dear student, delta, and delta is given, thickness is 10 raised power minus 4 meter, and the length it is L, and L is given as 1 meter, and the velocity of the water jo fall ho raha niche ki taraf, ye niche ki taraf fall ho raha, that is given as V average is equal to 0.01 meter per second. Width is not given, but I have assumed W is the width of the plate, okay, a wall, and the concentration jo vary kar raha, CA jo concentration hai at any given y, it is given by this equation CA bar at any given y, here, and obviously that should be correct. If we see that CA at y equal to 0 should be 0, why? Because water which are going to enter at y equal to 0, it is pure, then you can see the profile should be correctly matched with that result. CA bar is given as CI, as I told you, is the equilibrium concentration or solubility, it is 1 minus e to the power minus 30y. You can check it. At y equal to 0, CA should be what? 0, because water is pure. As water is going to fall down, and here gas is there, be careful, yahan pe gas hai. Here gases are there, this is a gas, and this gas is in the contact with the liquid, and so that as the, this is the liquid film, there is gas, and gas will try to dissolve in the liquid. That is the problem, that is the question, ki that gas is going to dissolve in the liquid water, and liquid is going to fall, and so that what happened, the concentration is going to vary along with the y direction. The only reason for variation of concentration is y, is what? The gas is going to dissolve, and as the gas is going to dissolve, then obviously your concentration is going to change with the distance, with the y direction. And now, and since the variation is in the y direction, then obviously we have to be assume a small differential element in which direction? Obviously in the y direction, because the variation of the concentration is in the y direction, so that I have to assume a small differential element in y direction. So here I have assumed a small differential element in y direction. Are you getting? That is your dy. This is small differential element. Now I am going to apply the balance, mole balance. Now as far as mole balance is concerned, the Na bar, let's say Na bar, bar means what? Rate, mole per second, the rate at which A is going to enter, and let's say it is distance y from origin, y, and it is dy. The Na bar at y, this is Na bar at y, this would be what? Na bar at y plus dy. The rate at which A is going to in, the rate at which A is going to out. My dear students, this should be only same if the gas is going to not dissolve. Am I right? This will be same if no gas is going to dissolve. But here, the gas is going to dissolve. Then obviously, we have to write this and this will not be equal to zero. Rate of A in at y minus rate of A at going to out from this differential section y plus dy. And this is in, this is going to out. And now one more thing is going to out, that's why it is going to not same, it is plus. What plus, my dear students? It is going to dissolve. Rate of transfer of solute is in, it is going to out, plus something is also going to in, and due to this in, what happened? This in and out will not be same. Alright? Now, then here, why this is equal to rate of transfer of solute, and this rate of transfer of solute is given by what? By the convective mass, in the terms of convective mass transfer coefficient or rate of convective mass transfer, that is obviously KL into obviously here the concentration is what? CAI, because CI what? Solubility minus in this element, because this element is very small, then we can assume that here the concentration is what? CAY. Okay, because I have assumed a small difference element, and we can assume the variation of CA here, CAY at any given Y, this is CAY, and since this difference element is very small, any variation we are going to neglect. Okay, now, and that is only what? Flux. But here I have written rate. Unit is very important. It is only mole per second per meter square, because it is a convective mass transfer flux. So we have to be multiply what? Area. Now, what should be area, my dear students? Area. Area is what? This is the area. Area through which the A is going to dissolve is what? dy into w. So this is dy into w. Am I right? Now, and this should be equal to 0 because process is steady state. That's it. Now, here, how can I write Na bar? Listen, this Na bar should be mole. Na bar is what? Concentration into velocity. Velocity is given as V bar. No need to worry about that. Concentration is obviously here CA bar at Y, because it is Y, into first of all here CA into velocity is what? Flux. CA bar, concentration, velocity, it is flux, minus here CA bar at Y plus dy. Am I right? Any problem? Again, it is bracket, velocity is also multiplied. I have taken the velocity common, but again it is flux, not rate. To find out the rate, we have to be multiply what? Area. And now, what should be area, my dear students? Area is should be, because A is going to enter from the top, then this area should be what? Cross sectional area for the velocities. Wherever the velocity is there, always we have to write the cross sectional area through which the flow is going to happen. Now, and in this case, the area should be what? Area should be here. This is delta, let's say thickness is delta into what? W. Delta into W is the cross sectional area. Delta into W is the cross sectional area. This is delta times W. Am I right? Okay. So this is the case here, and this should be, we can write, now this is rate minus of KL CAI minus CA at Y into DY into W. Now, and here I also, we can take common V bar delta W CA bar at Y plus DY minus CA bar at Y minus K of L CAI minus CAY into DY W. WW cancel, my dear students. Now minus minus cancel. Now, and divide the whole equation by DY. Divide the whole equation by and put limit dy tends to 0, then you will get what? V bar delta dCA at Y minus dy is equal to CAI minus CAY into KL. Okay, now further we can go for this to solve the equation. We can write here KL is found to be simple. I'm going to write the final equation. KL is equal to delta into V bar KL delta into V bar into DCA upon CAI minus CA bar at Y KL into DY into dy. If you integrate, KL is constant, and here integrate it. Okay, now we can also write KL into dy delta into V bar dCA upon CAI minus CA. Ye variable hai CAY. Now here limit is very important, my dear students. At Y equal to 0, listen, at Y equal to 0, what is CA here? 0. at, they have told you find out the average mass transfer coefficient through the length, then at y equal to L, this should be CA at y equal to L, am I right? Then here KL into L delta into V bar here into minus of ln CAI minus CA at y, limit is 0 to CA bar at y equal to L. And now if you solve, then KL is found to be delta into V bar upon L, here minus sign is there, into ln, this should be CAI minus CA bar at y equal to L upon CAI, that's it. Okay, now and everything is given to you in the problem, minus ko hum isko reverse kar denge, this is delta into V bar upon L into ln CAI minus CAI minus CA bar at y equal to L. Now then as from the question they have given, find the value of CA at y equal to L. Profile is given. Profile is given as what? Profile is given, my dear students, CAI into 1 minus e power minus 30 into y. Y kya arde hum? L kar de. L value kitni bache? 1. So CA bar at y equal to 1 equal to CAI minus CAI e power minus 30. Then here I have to put this value. Then CAI minus CA bar at y equal to 1 is found to be CAI e power minus 30. Now just I am going to put value here, then it is KL equal to delta into V bar upon L into ln CAI upon CAI e power minus 30. It is cancelled out, then KL is found to be delta into V bar upon L into ln e power 30. Ln e power 30 is 30, then KL is equal to delta into V bar upon L into 30. Now my dear student, delta is given. Delta is thickness is given as what? 10 is per minus 4 meter, and average velocity is given as 0.01, length is given as 1 meter, and it is 30. If you solve, you will get what? You will get around, answer is 3 into 10 per minus of 5 meter per second, that is your KL average. Okay, then in mm per second they have asked you, then 3 into 10 power minus 5 into 10 power 3 mm per second, obviously here, then you will get 3 into 10 power of what? Minus 2 mm per second, and that is what? 0.03 mm per second. That is your answer. Are you getting? So this is the concept here, and this concept we have discussed many times in the heat transfer. We have to consider the what? Cell balance. Now there is one more method to solve this question based on LMTD. Logarithmic mean. Whenever these types of problem is there, always go for logarithmic mean difference. Okay, that I will discuss later on. Okay, so that was the topic as we have discussed. Now next lecture mein, in the next lecture we'll further discuss the other questions, and also one more thing I want to discuss with you people, that already and especially to my students, all of you have done your tremendous effort. Aapne bahut hi acha kiya hai aur maine response sheet dekhe hai, and on the behalf of response sheet, on the behalf of marks I have calculated, I can say that our students are again going to secure under 10 rank, and all under 10 rank will be from our classrooms students only. Okay, some of them will be also from the other courses, online courses, crash course courses. Okay, and but still you all have done very good effort, and main personally aap log ko appreciate karta hu, aur kai sare aise examples bhi aapko main show karne wala hu, dikhaunga ki jinhone last year ye mera pre declared result hai, jinhone last year 1500 rank laye the, now this year they are going to secure 3 rank, second rank, and even the fourth rank also. Even they have not clear some, one more students is there who, and now one more very important things I want to share with you. There is one more guy बिकॉज हमारे दिमाग में क्या होता है कि द स्टूडेंट्स टॉपर्स आर ऑलवेज फ्रॉम द IITs और NITs, बट ये भी मिथ को फेल करने के लिए एक और स्टूडेंट्स आपके सामने आएगा वीडियो के साथ, अपने एक्सपीरियंस शेयर करने के साथ, जिसने प्राइवेट कॉलेज से बीटेक किया। और ये मेरा बहुत ही दिली इच्छा थी कि मैं एक बार ऐसा शो करूं, एक ऐसा स्टूडेंट्स को प्लेटफॉर्म पर खड़ा करूं जो टॉप 5 रैंक में हो, टॉप 3 रैंक में हो और वो प्राइवेट कॉलेज से बीटेक किया हो। चैलेंजेस मुझे पसंद है, किसी ने चैलेंज किया था नाउ, और बहुत सारे ऐसे बच्चे हैं जिन्होंने किसी भी NIT से, किसी भी IIT से, किसी भी रेपुटेड कॉलेज से बीटेक नहीं किया, बट दे आर गोइंग टू सिक्योर अंडर 10 रैंक। और कुछ ऐसे बच्चे हैं जो क्वालिफाई भी नहीं किए थे, नाउ दे आर गोइंग टू सिक्योर द अंडर 10 रैंक। ओके, देन बी ट्यून्ड एंड बी कॉन्फिडेंट, एंड दैट वीडियो विल वेरी वेरी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू टू नो हाउ टू प्रिपेयर द गेट एग्जामिनेशन। ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच फ्रॉम ऑल AI टीम्स। थैंक यू।